Hi, welcome back to ChargerLAB. Today we will tear down a unique ultra-thin charger, the Realme 50W Mini SuperDart Charger, which is completely different from the other chargers we have torn down. The packaging is yellow and very thin. The front side is printed Realme 50W Mini SuperDart Charger with cable. Turn it back, we can see the model is RMP2006. It supports wild voltage input of 100 to 240 volts and output of 5 volts 6A or 10 volts 5A. When connected to 100 to 130 volts AC, it supports 5 volts 1.5A, 9 volts 1A. When connected to 180 to 240 volts AC, it supports 5 volts 3A, 9 volts 3A and 3.3 to 11 volts 3A PPS. Open the box, we can see the charger directly, and the cable and manual are below. This is a flat cable which is easier to arrange. The length of this cable is about 100 cm. Then back to the ultra thin charger. It adopts pure white and the shell is glossy plastic, very smooth. The folding pins occupied one third of the back. The other side is the USB-C port. The plastic insertion is also white. The specification here is the same as what's printed on the packaging. Let's see the charger size. The length is 81mm, width is 39mm, and the thickness is only 10mm. Weight is 55 grams. So the power density is about 1.5 watts per cubic centimeter, which is way more beyond the excellent standard of 1 watt cubic centimeter. Compared to Apple 30 watts and 61 watts power adapter, the Realme charger is obviously smaller. Finally, let's use the ChargerLAB Power ZKM001C to test it. Try to charge the Oppo smartphone, and it can successfully trigger the SuperVogue protocol and support QC and PD protocol as well. Then let's tear it down. Continue. The rectangular planar transformer is in the middle, and the thermal pad is attached to the front and back sides of the PCB, and then continue to clean up the module. This is a planar transformer, and a layer of insulating tape is on the back. To reduce the thickness, planar transformer is inserted into the PCB. Only in this way can it be ultra-thin. The input capacitors, inductors, and other components will be SMD components. ChargerLAB found this charger used switching power supply to output wide-range voltage, and then the protocol chip will control the output voltage. This is a time delay fuse, 1.6 amp 250 volts. Common mode choke is covered with plastic case. Remove it and we can see the glue for reinforcement. This is an I-shaped inductor used for input filtering. It integrates clamping diodes for overvoltage protection in primary circuit, which can prove overvoltage of capacitors and switch transistors. This is the rectifier bridge, model is RTBS30M. The input adopts three high voltage MLCC filters packaged by 2220. Which can solve the thickness problem caused by traditional cylindrical capacitors. The ACF controller comes from Texas Instruments UCC28782, which integrates X capacitor to discharge and power management chip, and can reduce EMI interference. The gate driver comes from ON Semiconductor NCP51530B. It can be used as two GaN switch transistors to drive ACF architecture when cooperating with ACF controller. This is Navitas GaN switch transistor packaged by QFN 5×6mm. Model is NV6115. It integrates 170mA resistance and supports 2 MHz switching frequency, with standard voltage is 650 volts. Here is another Navitas NV6115 chip. The USB receptacle port is inserted into the output side. The optocoupler is located on this small board, model is TLP383. There are 4 Y capacitors on the back of the optocoupler, 2 in series and 2 in parallel. This is MPS Synchronous Rectifier Controller, model is MP6908A. It supports synchronous rectifiers driven by standard voltage and logic voltage. Maximum operating frequency is 600 kHz. The secondary synchronous rectifier comes from Infineon BSZ070N08LS. Its withstand voltage is 80 volts and resistance is 7 milliohm. Kemmer's tantalum capacitors are in here, used for output filtering. Specification is 150 microfarad, 16 volts. They can reduce the size and are suitable for the high switching frequency of GaN chargers. Here is the parallel MLCC capacitor, working with tantalum capacitor and used for filtering after synchronous rectification. The output protocol chip comes from Richtek. The output VBUS switch transistor comes from Infineon BSC0902NS. With standard voltage is 30 volts and resistance is 2.6 milliohm. Finally, remove the transformer. And this is the core of the planar transformer. Okay, that's all components of this ultra-thin Realme 50W charger. We can find the key to reducing the size of the charger is because it adopts ceramic capacitors and clamping diodes of airplanes. In addition, it adopts the more common planar transformer and GaN material. Only in this case can it create such an ultra-thin charger. So for this kind of special charger, are you interested in buying one? You can tell us the reason below. And if you have any suggestions or advice, you can also leave your comments. And this is ChargerLAB. Please subscribe to us for the next video. Bye!